That's true enough. This afternoon, the county attorney said that perhaps because of the location of the home and the affluence of the neighborhood. But that's probably some of the most upsetting information that came out of this afternoon's press conference is there was no rhyme or reason, no connection to the Quesadas. Investigators believe these two men broke in, probably just planning on burglarizing the place. That's when Dr. and Sonia Quesada walked in, surprising them. And that's when this crime took a savage turn.
November 24th, 7 Proclamation Court. Dr. Eduardo Quesada and his wife Sonia return home to find intruders. Today, nearly 5 months later, there is disturbing new information about the vicious attack unleashed on the couple with screwdrivers.
Dr. Quesada was stabbed in the head multiple times with a screwdriver, resulting in facial fractures, lacerations, and brain injury. Mrs. Quesada was sexually and physically assaulted, which resulted in the loss of sight in her left eye, amongst other serious injuries.
Investigators say their case was stalled, in part because the doctor and his wife were so injured they couldn't be interviewed. Sonia died January 7th in an unrelated event at her mother-in-law's home. Also in January, investigators got a break that led to an arrest warrant being issued today for 32-year-old Charles Normal, seen here in a mugshot from an arrest in 2009. Normal is currently in custody in Massachusetts, charged with a home invasion in Methuen that included assault and battery with a dangerous weapon. A second suspect is in custody but was not named because he's being prosecuted by the U.S. Attorney's Office.
Thus far, investigators have uncovered no connection between Mr. Normal and Dr. Quesada or his family. It appears the initial motivation was financial in nature.
Only News 9 was there Tuesday when dive teams searched two ponds in Amherst and Milford, taking items from one of them. Investigators called their findings icing on the cake for this case. Police battled public criticism for being tight-lipped when the community was clamoring for answers. Today, they defended that strategy.
I also want the residents of Bedford to know that the non-disclosure of case-sensitive information was absolutely essential and critical in helping us achieve these investigative results.
No timeline on when Charles Normal will be back here in New Hampshire to be officially charged. That's because he's being held in Massachusetts. If he chooses to waive extradition, he'll be brought up here. If he chooses to fight extradition, the governor of New Hampshire issues him a warrant, ordering him back to the state to face charges on felonious sexual assault, attempted murder, and burglary. He's due in court in Massachusetts in May to face charges in that event. For now, we're live in Bedford. Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.
Amy, a quick question before you get away. Do we know how long Charles Normal has been in custody?
Yeah, a little confusion there. This afternoon, the county attorney said that he's been in jail in Massachusetts since December, but officials in Methuen tell us they don't have him booked in until February.